After dinner and everyone taking their place, the chimpanzees call it a day. They spend about 8 to 9 hours of sleep on these platforms. And for us, well, we'll just see you in the morning. It's 6:30 a.m. and the sun is up. The chimpanzees are lying in wait for their first meal of the day, but they have to wait until 8 a.m. Luckily for them, Joseph, their caregiver, is already preparing their breakfast. Now, chimpanzees are classified as omnivores, which means that like us humans, they can eat both plant and actually animal products. It's 10:30 a.m. and I'm here with Joseph, an animal caregiver, and we are going to prepare the chimpanzee meal for 11 a.m.
Second meal, and this is our food menu that guides us. Every time we shouldn't compromise the food. To meet their diet. So this is our guideline. We know that at this time we are feeding this and it has all the kilograms that a chimpanzee has to eat every day. Chimps eat 10% of their body weight, so this is organized in a way that they can really meet the amount of food they need in their bodies. So after understanding every chimpanzee how big it is, then this can be done according to the number of chimps and how many kilograms do they have to balance that. Have a cassava on my menu. I'll be also having oranges. I also have a cucumber, and then I'll be having some watermelon and also the avocados for my menu for this time.
The chimpanzee diet varies, comprising of leaves, seeds, fruits, plus flowers. They also engage in targeting hunting of lower order primates, such as the red colobus and bush babies, and use the meat from these kills as a social tool within their community. According to Joseph, they are fed 4 times a day.
Well, I'm not done with preparing the second time of feeding. The food that is going to be fed right now, I have the cassava, I have the watermelon, I have a cucumber, and then I have the oranges. Then the next feeding that's going to be at 2:30 is going to be a different menu that will comprise of carrots, I have the pineapples, I have the jackfruit, I have the tomatoes, then I'll have some kind of like eggplants for that. Then the last meal, which is at 6:30, they normally eat porridge, which is mixed up with the soya flour to make sure that we can give them much protein. In that last meal. The breakfast that is always served at 8 o'clock is always posho and ripe bananas. Technically, chimpanzees eat vegetables and fruits, and by reason why we do that is to balance their diet, and we shouldn't want to compromise what they can eat in the wild. So we feed according to their body demand and what is required. You need to emphasize cleanliness. Generally, hygiene is very important because we shouldn't want to contaminate. We need to sort out the food that is going bad so that we cannot cause any germs to the chimpanzees.
As much as I'd really love to help right now, I cannot, because we share 98.7% DNA with chimpanzees, and that in itself presents a huge risk of disease transmissions from us to them or them to us. So right now I'm just going to let Joseph get to it, because I would have to require a vaccination procedure that cannot be facilitated right now. But after this, we are going to go all the way to where they are and feed them, because it's almost 11 a.m. and it's their second feeding meal of the day.
According to the vets, they say Isoro is encouraged to have more of the starch food in the morning hours.
The starch food? Starch?
Starch food.
Oh, starch food in
the
morning
energy
hours.
Giving food, yeah.
Ah, okay.
Before we start feeding, they take positions, and instead of having three buckets positioned in two different directions, to make sure that we can at least reach every chimpanzee.
Every chimpanzee.
Because when you throw food at the same point, the more high-ranking ones have the upper chance to take almost everything. So when there's one bucket in the corner, like Joseph Foyer is, then Grace in the middle, and I'll be this side. We have chances that everyone can have a chance to get food.
Right, so I've also seen you call out their names when you're giving them food. Is it just so that the others know that it's this one's turn in particular, or?
There are times when we can control, especially when they're in the rooms, mm-hmm. we can control, and if I call the name, specifically that chimpanzee will respond.
Okay.
Yeah. Even here, when I call, there's the way we can communicate. If some others are more overriding others, we can be in position to say like some kind of communication, and they will understand. Just in case.
All right, so just a trial basis.
Yeah.
What's his name?
That is a she. She's called Pasa.
Oh, his name.
Yeah.
This is Pasa.
Yep.
And this one?
That's Sophie.
Sophie and
Ekuru.
I'm sure by tomorrow I would have forgotten all that.